Hi guys, today I'm going to cover how to stop a car engine from overheating. I'll also cover the common causes of overheating and how you can troubleshoot and walk through these in order to get your car back on the road as soon as possible. Knowing what to do when the temperature gauge begins to rise or has entered the red zone can prevent irreversible engine damage and save you a huge repair bill. Now let's get this. Temperature for most cars would often sit just about halfway on the temperature gauge, sometimes slightly under or slightly above, depending on the car you're driving. If you're driving and notice that the temperature gauge is going beyond the normal point, you should quickly do the following. First, if you're using your AC for cooling, you should shut this off. A car AC simply takes the heat that is in the cabin and moves it to the condenser, which is in close proximity to the radiator and in the engine bay. In essence, your car engine will run hotter with the AC on. Shutting off the AC will take some stress off the engine. 2. Turn the AC to max heat, set the fan on the highest and roll down the windows. This simple act turns the AC evaporator, which is under the dash, into a second radiator. Most cars just use the heat from the engine bay to warm up the cabin. Doing this may reduce the engine temperature and keep the car from overheating, depending on the cause of the overheating in the first place. The next thing to do once you get the chance is to pull over and shut the car off, especially if the temperature gauge is already in the red zone. This will help prevent burning your head gasket as well as warping the cylinder head if these have not occurred already. 4. Once pulled over, you may leave the car off or have the ignition on for a bit. This will do two things. First, with the engine temperature above normal, the cooling fan should remain on with the key in the engine off key on position. This will help further cool down the engine. Contrary to what you may think, once you shut off the engine, the temperature actually rises before it starts to cool. This is because the coolant no longer circulates, as well as the ram of air that heats the radiator and provides some level of cooling no longer happens. Secondly, leaving the ignition on may give you the first clue of what the cause of overheating is. If the fans do not come on when you do this, then that tells you that the possible cause of your overheating is a defective cooling fan, a relay, or the radiator or cooling fan switch. We'll talk more on this later. The fifth thing you should do is to allow the hood to get cool to touch. Also ensure that you don't have any high pressure hissing sounds coming from the engine bay before you attempt to pop the hood. This may be hot coolant or gases escaping from a broken coolant hose or radiator. Also take the time to look under the vehicle to find out if there's any coolant leaks or oil leaks collecting at the bottom of the vehicle. Now, while waiting for our imaginary overheated engine to cool down, we should go through the causes of overheating, as this will be helpful when it comes to things you should look out for when you finally pop the hood. One of the commonest causes of engine overheating is inadequate coolant in the cooling system. This may be from a leak, underfilling the coolant, or from not bleeding air from the cooling system after a refill. I once had a subscriber contact me about an overheating issue. He had done a drain and refill recently. Turns out he only added 1/3 of the required coolant. 2. A broken serpentine belt. This is usually easy to diagnose because with the rising engine temperature, you will also have the battery light illuminate on the dash because the serpentine belt is no longer driving the alternator and charging the battery. 3. A defective cooling fan. This may range from inadequate speed to the fan being totally unfunctional. 4. Is a broken cooling or radiator fan relay. This is one problem I've experienced in the past. Relay problems can sometimes be intermittent before they fail completely, so you may have that issue of overheating happening sometimes and not every time. 5. A stuck thermostat. This will not allow the colder coolant to flow from the radiator into the engine for cooling. Number 6. Insufficient oil in the crankcase. In addition to lubrication, oil also acts as a coolant, and severe oil leaks can lead to overheating. 7. A clogged radiator. This includes clogging of the external fins as well as internal cooling pathways. A broken head gasket will allow oil and coolant to form an emulsion, which can clog cooling pathways. Also, a broken water pump will fail to pump coolant throughout the engine and overheating will result. These are the main causes of overheating. Now that the engine has cooled to touch, you can proceed to detailed troubleshooting. Once you pop the hood, you can begin to rule out the different causes of engine overheating as mentioned previously. If it's a broken serpentine belt, radiator, or cooling hoses, those should be pretty obvious. Next, check the oil dipstick and making sure that the radiator cap is now cooled to touch, check the level of the coolant. Low oil or coolant level in either of those compartments is a pointer to the cause of overheating. To rule out defective cooling fans, you may want to directly connect 12 volts to the fan or use an active scan tool to command the fans to come on. If the fan comes on while using the scan tool, that tells you that the radiator fan as well as the radiator relay are all good. Although if it's a car with a single fan that works by speed variation, you will need to do further testing to establish whether both low and high speed functions are intact. You may also do this manually by observing the speed of the fan with or without the AC on. With the AC on, the fan should run at a higher speed. If using a scan tool and the fan doesn't come on, you have to rule out a broken relay or a short in the wiring. You can easily swap similar relays in the fuse box to rule out a defective relay. Also inspect the fan wiring for rodent activity or other signs of a short. For a stock thermostat, there's a simple test to rule this out. Most thermostats begin to open at about 81 degrees centigrade, and after 91 degrees centigrade they are usually fully open. To test this, connect a scan tool that has access to live data where you can see coolant temperature. Most basic scan tools have this. Here's where a wireless scan tool is nice, otherwise you can have a body assist you. You will observe that after starting the car from cold, the upper radiator hose is going to begin to get hot while the lower one would stay cool. This is because the thermostat stays closed and is not allowing the coolant to flow from the radiator into the engine. When the coolant temperature by live data begins to approach 81 degrees centigrade, the lower hose will begin to get hot. If the lower radiator hose remains cooler even at operating temperature, then you're definitely dealing with a closed thermostat. Establishing a defective coolant or radiator switch or temperature sensor is pretty easy. Allow the car to cool completely to ambient temperature. Again, through live data, the temperature of the intake air temperature sensor and the coolant temperature sensor should be about the same with the car cold. If you start the car and the coolant temperature changes drastically or behaves erratically, the coolant fan switch or equivalent is likely bad. So this is how to stop your car from overheating, as well as how to troubleshoot the causes of overheating. Hope this has been helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace.